Hello students, welcome to chemistry class. Today our topic is types of errors. Errors, the definition is the difference between the observed or measured value and the true or accepted value in an analysis. Errors will affect the accuracy and the precision any of measurements seriously. They are mainly classified into two types. The first one is random or indeterminate errors. The second one is systematic or determinate errors. Random or indeterminate errors. Errors whose magnitude cannot be determined and their effects cannot be eliminated are called random errors. These errors cause the small random variations in a measured value when the measurement is repeated a number of times. These errors will affect the precision of measurements. Greater the errors, lesser will be the precision. And these errors are occurring accidentally. Hence, they are also called accidental errors. Next, systematic or determinate errors. As the name implies that errors whose magnitude can be determined and their effects can be eliminated or at least reduced are called random errors. These errors cause the measured values to differ from the true or accepted value. And determinate errors will affect the accuracy of the results. Greater the errors, lesser will be the accuracy. Now, move on to the methods of detection and elimination of systematic errors. As I said in the previous slide, errors whose magnitude can be determined and their effects can be eliminated or at least reduced are called systematic errors. They are further classified as instrumental errors, methodic errors, personal or operative errors. Instrumental errors. These errors are caused by the use of defective instruments and instabilities in their power supplies. These errors are usually detected and eliminated by calibration. Periodic calibration of the instrument is always desirable because the response of most instruments like potentiometer, conductometer changes with time as a result of wear, corrosion or mistreatment. Methodic errors. These errors are arised due to faulty method or procedure used in the experiment. Systematic errors may be usually detected and eliminated by many methods. The first one is by using standard samples. The best way of determining this type of error is by using the analysis with a standard reference material. They are prepared by synthesis or purchased from a number of governmental or industrial sources. Next, by using independent analysis. If standard samples are not available, a second independent or reliable method can be performed parallel to the analytical method being evaluated. This is possible to minimize the error, that is, some common factor in the sample has the same effect on both the methods, so you can reduce the methodic errors by doing independent analysis. Next, by running a blank determination. In blank determination, all steps of the analysis are performed in the absence of the sample. Blank determination is useful to detect errors due to interfering contaminants from the reagents and the vessels employed in analysis. The results from the blank are then applied as a correction to the sample measurements. Okay. Finally, variation in sample size. As the size of the sample increases, the effect of systematic error decreases. Hence, this type of errors can usually be detected and eliminated by running the experiment with varying the sample size. The third type is personal errors or operative errors. These errors are caused by the carelessness, inattention, physical inability, and wrong way of handling the instrument. Another source of personal error is prejudice or bias. Most of the personal errors can be minimized by care and self-discipline. It's a good habit to check the instrument readings carefully, notebook entries properly, and doing calculations systematically. Now you understood the effects of errors. So you should avoid them as much as possible, otherwise your results will be useless. Okay, thank you.